ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ. ನನಗೆ ಕನ್ನಡ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಗೊತ್ತು, ತುಂಬ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗೇ ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ಐ ಸ್ಪೀಕ್ ಇನ್ ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್. ಸೊ ದ ಡ್ಯೂರೇಷನ್ ಇಸ್ ಟಿಲ್ 12 o'clock. ಐ ಆಮ್ ವೆರಿ ಸರ್ಪ್ರೈಸ್ಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪಿ ದಟ್ ವಿ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟೆಡ್ 15 minutes ಅರ್ಲಿ. ಸೊ ನಾರ್ಮಲಿ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಐ ಸೀನ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಡಿಲೇ ಹ್ಯಾಪನಿಂಗ್. ಇಟ್ಸ್ ವೆರಿ ನೈಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸಚ್ ಎ ನೈಸ್ ಆಡಿಯನ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ಸೊ ಮೇನ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ಮ್ಯೂಸಿಕ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಆಫ್ ರಾಗಂ ತಾನಂ ಪಲ್ಲವಿ. ಪಲ್ಲವಿ ವಿ ಟೇಕ್ ಒನ್ ಲೈನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಡೂ ನರವಿಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಮೇಕ್ ದಟ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಲೈನ್ ಬಿಗ್. ಸೊ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ 2 points ಟು ಮೇಕ್. ಸೊ ದೋಸ್ 2 points ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಎಲಾಬರೇಟ್ ಲಿಟಲ್. ಒನ್, ದಟ್ ಇಫ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಎ ಐಡಿಯಲ್ ಸಿಂಗರ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಗುಡ್ ದಟ್ ವಿ ನೋ ಅನ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರೂಮೆಂಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಇಫ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಎ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರೂಮೆಂಟಲಿಸ್ಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಗುಡ್ ಇಫ್ ವಿ ನೋ ಸಿಂಗಿಂಗ್. ದಟ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ ಐ ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಟೆಲ್. ಸೊ ಬಟ್ ಸಮ್ ವಿತ್ ಸಮ್ ಇಲ್ಲುಸ್ಟ್ರೇಷನ್ಸ್. ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಸೋ ಮೆನಿ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ಸ್ ಟು ಇಲ್ಲುಸ್ಟ್ರೇಟ್ ದೀಸ್ 2 points. ಸೊ ಈಚ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಟಾಕ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಸೆವೆರಲ್ ಅವರ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಐ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಟಚ್ ಆನ್ ಲಿಟಲ್ ಬಿಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಡೂ ದ ಲೆಕ್ಚರ್. ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಕಾನ್ಸಂಟ್ರೇಟ್ ಆನ್ ವೈ ಎ ಸಿಂಗರ್ ಶುಡ್ ನೋ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರೂಮೆಂಟ್, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಟು ಡೆಮಾನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರೇಟ್ ದ ಅದರ್ ಆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಅ ಲಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಯು ಟು ಬ್ರಿಂಗ್ ಮೈ ವೀಣಾ ಅಂಡ್ ಸ್ಟಫ್. ಸೊ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ give you an example. For example, a person, we call it gayaki, which is the vocal style, and tantrakari, which is the instrumental style. So if a person knows an instrument but they don't know singing at all, then suppose they play mahaganapati and mahakavya natakadi priya, so they don't know it's natakadi priya. So so kadipriyam kadipriyam, so it has no sense at all. So same way if we play pancharatnam, for example, the way we cut the swarams when we sing swaram and the way we cut when we sing sahityam will be different. So for example, sa sa sani ni sani ni sani pa ma pa ni sa ji ri ga ri ri ga ri ri ga ri ri ga ri ri sa ga ri ri sa ni. So an instrumentalist who does not know singing, they will play the same thing 2 times. So once it is swaram, once it is sahityam. But when we know sahityam, we can cut sa ma ga na lo la, and instead of manasi jala manasi jala vanya dhanya and then cut again mudhanyulu. So not garire 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 sa, so before sa one cut with it. Same with all, I don't want to sing the whole pancharatnam, but just give you an example. I won't sing swaram now. ಮಾನಸ ವನಚರ ವರ ಸಂಚಾರ ಮುನಿಲಿಪಿ ಮೂರ್ತಿ ಬಾಗುಗ ಒಡಗನೆ ಬಾರು. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಲಿಟಲ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ವೆನ್ ವಿ ಕಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಸರಂ ಪಪ ಮರಿ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಸರಗುಣ ಪ. ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಸರಗುಣ ಪ, ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಸರಗುಣ ಪಾದಮುಲ. ಸೊ ವೆನ್ ವಿ ಪ್ಲೇ ಆನ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರೂಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಶೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಮೈ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಆಟೋಮ್ಯಾಟಿಕಲಿ, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಐ ಪ್ಲೇ ವೀಣಾ ಇಟ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಟ್, ಅದರ್ವೈಸ್ ವಯಲಿನ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್. ಸೊ ಸರಗುಣ ಪಾದಮುಲಕು ಸ್ವಾಂತಮನು ಸರೋಜಮುನು ಸಮರ್ಪಣಮು ಜೇಯುವಾರು ಪತಿತ ಪಾವನುಡನೆ. ಸೊ ಸಸನಿ ಪ ಕಟ್ ತ್ರೀ ಸನಿ ಪ ಕಟ್ ಗರಿ ಸನ್, ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಹೌ ವಿಲ್ ಪ್ಲೇ ವೆನ್ ವಿ ಪ್ಲೇ ಸ್ವರ. ಬಟ್ ವೆನ್ ವಿ ಸಿಂಗ್ ಸಾಹಿತ್ಯ ಪತಿತ ಪಾವನುಡನೆ ಪರಾತ್ಪರುನಿ ಗುರಿಂಚಿ ಪರಮಾರ್ಥಮಗು ನಿಜ ಮಾರ್ಗಮು ತೋನು ಪಾಡುಚುನು ಸಲ್ಲಪಮುತು ಸರಳಯಾದಿ ರಾಗಮುನ ತೆರಿಯು. ಸೊ ದೆನ್ ವೆನ್ ಎ ಲಿಸ್ನರ್ ನೋಸ್ ದ ಸಾಹಿತ್ಯ, ಈವನ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಪ್ಲೇಯಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ ಎನ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರೂಮೆಂಟ್ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ದ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೇ ನಾಟ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ದ ಸ್ವರಮ್ಸ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಅಗೇನ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಒನ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ದ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಗಿವ್ ಯು ಎನ್ ಇಲ್ಲುಸ್ಟ್ರೇಷನ್. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ Veena Balachandra, who was self-taught in everything. He taught himself singing, he taught himself ganjira, he taught himself veena, he taught himself film making. So he acted, he gave music for films, he sang, he did so many things. But just, this is available in public domain in YouTube itself. So I'll play just one small bit. You can listen and then go home and search for Veena Balachandar, Raghupati Raghava Raja. So everybody knows Raghupati Raghava Raja. But it is not only knowing Sahityam, but feeling the Sahityam, the intonation, how the same plucking will be hard and soft. It is like singing only. I'll give you one small example. Of course, Balachandar was very brilliant and very eccentric also. That eccentricity also comes through. How many varieties Raghupati Raghava he gives you, see? We have two Rajas who are getting awarded this time. So, Naga Raja. Now only song is starting. See, cutting. Such a popular song, one line, Raghupati Raghava Raja. how many varieties he is giving, and we forget we are hearing an instrument. We are hearing Raghupati Raghavara. Not Nisa, 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 Nisa. We are not hearing swarams. So that happens when the instrumentalist has singing inside them. So I was privileged to learn a little bit of singing from some extraordinary gurus, and some veena also from some other extraordinary gurus, and interact closely with a few people, some of whom are still alive, some who are not, who were multiple disciplinary. My second Guruji, Dr. Mangalampalli Balamurli Krishna, said he used to play violin, viola, mridangam, vajira, and sing and compose also. Currently, I am very close to Dr. T.V. Gopalakrishnan, who plays violin, mridangam, sings and composes. So the insights they give, they are very precious. Many people, what happens is that, suppose I am a teenager who is learning veena, they generally listen to other people play veena only. So then their listening becomes very limited. So suppose I am a veena student, I should listen to nadaswaram and violin and so flute and so many other instruments, and of course singing, and try and take. For example, I am very attracted to the violin style of Paroor M.S. Gopalakrishnan. So, particularly M.S. Gopalakrishnan. So many things he does, I try to bring both in my voice and in my veena. So, though he was not a veena player, and though I am not a violin player. So, one thing I find is that, generally, when people talk bad about others, the singers will always say, he's an instrumentalist, he doesn't know Sahitya. If we sing Goa Bharav, Padani pa maga gama pa pa ma padani sa pa mag, that's how they're playing. They don't know it's Brova Bharama Raghuna. So while instrumentalists will say about singers that they are just singing, they hear, and because of years of practice, after some time they sing the correct phrases, but without really knowing what the gamakam is and where it starts, how much is the measure of the shaking. So I hear both these, and mostly I keep my ears open and mouth shut. Actually, I prefer to sit there and listen to somebody else talk more than, because we can always learn. If we are going on talking, means we can't learn anything new. So, generally I love listening, and when a person is talking, they know you are listening well, means they will share more. So, I find in Carnatic music, what defines Carnatic music from, as a different thing from any other system, though we have the same 12 notes, is our Gamaka system. So, normally when vocal teachers, many of them teach students, from the beginning Maya Malagona lessons itself, they start with Gamaka, which I feel it's better if we get the Shuddha Swaram position correct first and then do Gamakam than just do Gamakam from the beginning. So, for example, first thing we sing is Sapasa. So, many people, if you listen carefully, you will find that they are saying sa re. So that itself will be re sa. Two notes will be there for sa. Sa, then pa will be ga pa. Sa, so already Mohanam has come. Sa re ga pa da sa has come. Sa pa sa. Like, and students will also repeat like. So I think sa pa sa is just two plain notes. Then the positions of the 12 notes, it doesn't matter which raga. Sa, then small re, then big re, small ga, then big ga, then small ma, then big ma, then pa, then small da, then small ni, big ni, and sa. So, sa, ni, ni, da, ga, ga, ma, ma, ga. See, these, like a keyboard in our brain and in our throat, the position of the 12 notes should be like diamonds, they'll be studded like that. Then we do gamakams. So, even the reason that if you look at Hindustani music or Western music, they generally do basic lessons in of equivalent of our Shankaravarnam notes, which are all Sudraswarams, pure notes, not flat or sharp, that's what I meant. While we do Mayamalagoda, generally, whether we are in Karnataka, Kerala, Tamil Nadu, anywhere, our basic exercises are done in Maya Malagoda. So one that I have asked so many big people, why Maya Malagoda, and different people have given different opinions, all of which I have found very logical. One is that earlier, if a student studied music, means automatically Veena will also be there. So for a small child, 5 years old, 6 years old, Veena is a big instrument. The fingerboard will be very big and their fingers will be very small. So each pair of notes are very close. Nuzari will be together, Gama will be together, Pada will be together, Nisa. So the small fingers they can keep near Sari, Gama, Pada, Nisa. That is one reason. Another reason is that the gaps between notes, Sari is next. So same with Gama, Pada, Nisa also. But Ma, Pa, Ma, Pa, with Ma, then Ma, that area. So two note gap. Ma, Pa, Ma, Pa is there. And Zadri, Ga, Ri, Ga, and Pa, Da, Ni, Da, Ni. So there is three note gap. So all three forms of gaps are there in the same raga. Then some, suppose we use the small Gandhara, Ga, can also be third value Ri. While in Mahamala Gaula, all the notes, Mahamala Gaula Ri can only be Ri, it can't be some other note. Ga can only be Ga, it can't be a Ri. So like that, the Mahamala Gaula Swarams don't have the option of being any other Swaram than Sarigama Pare. This is another reason. But let us take one Gama. My talking, I can either talk in a way that the driver who brought me, he will also understand. It will be so simple. Or it will be very technical, but when I see the audience, if I say the technical things, all the people in the front row, you know this already, I don't have to tell you. But I'll try and explain in a way which hopefully everybody or most people will understand and enjoy. It's too technical also, some people may not understand. But just take one note. In Mahamala Gaula, we move the Gandharam. In Shankarabharanam, the Gandharam is steady, but we move the Madhyam. But what we call Gamaka in common parlance, though it may sound scandalous, it's a kind of lie only. We are saying name of one note but singing some other note. Especially in ragas like Darba, Arga and all that. What we sing and what we say is very, very different. So if we take Mahamala Gaula Gandharam, Sari Ga, Ma is playing. So Ga, we are saying Ga only, but it is Ma Ga Ma Ga Ma Ga Ma Ga is the content. But what we are saying is Ga. When Shankarabharanam, we are saying Ma, but it is 80% Ga only. So Re Ga Ma. So Ga only, Ga Ma Ga. Ma. So in Shankarabharanam we are saying Ma, which is full of Ga, while in Mahamala Gaula we are saying Ga, which is full of Ma. So these things, if you don't know an instrument, you have to listen and gradually get it. But if you know an instrument, then instantly, easily we understand, oh okay, this is like this. Even what is grammatically in a paper and what we sing. For example, again with Gamakams, Shankarabharanam and Kalyani, what is the difference? Shankarabharanam has small Ma, Kalyani has big Ma, that is all. But without Ma, there is no difference. Actually, everything is different. Ri is different, Ga is different. Pa, of course, is not different. Sa, except Sa, Pa, the other notes are very different in how we handle in Shankarabharanam and Kalyani. Though on paper, only one note is different. So, I'm not saying all situations is like that, but one general thing we can tell is that in Shankarabharanam, we take each note by pulling from the note below. So from Sa, we are dragged like 10 kilos weight. We are dragging to Ri. So when we sing Sa, then when we say Ri, we are still in Sa only. So Ri, no. We are saying Ri and staying in Sa. So, Ri. Ri. So from Sa Gari 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 Ri Ga Ga. From Gari Ga, then we are saying Ma, but we are still on Ga. Ma Pa Da. da is this place only. But from da ni, so pasada dasani sa. So pasada dasani sa only is the x-ray of da ni sa. So each note we are taking from down. Re ga ma pa da ni sa. While Kalyani, again, as I said, it's not 100% of the time, but generally, each note comes from the note above. Instead of sari, sari, ga, so kari, maga, and we don't know ma, ma, pa, ma, pa, ma, pa, ma, sari, ga, ma, pa, da, ni, sa, ni, da, pa, re, ga, sa. So, just ma is the difference, but actually all notes are different. And our ragas, the great people have made in such a beautiful way that generally speaking, there will be one note steady and one note moving. If everything is gamakam, also is a problem. So that is one point I wanted. So Shankaravarnam, for example, my ancestor Maharaja Swaditrinal has made a varnam, Chalamela, which many of you will know. So if we know Veena and we pay attention and play, it is different from if we just simply play. For example, there is one set of swarams which lead to pachama. So pa da pa ma pa ma ga ma pa ga re sa ni da pa da ni sa di sa pa ma pa da pa ni da ni pa sa ni da pa ni da ma pa da ni sa pa re ga ma pa pa ga 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 ga. Like this is a charanam swara. But if what I sang now is completely zero value. The value comes when we connect the previous note to pa with the appropriate gamaka. For example, same pa, pa da pa ma pa, so pa, that is the gamaka. Pa da pa ma pa, ma ga ma pa, so ma ga ma pa, ga re sa ni da pa, pa, da ni sa re sa pa, so they are playing. Sa pa, da ni sa pa, re ga ma pa, pa ga ga ja. So this, our own enjoyment will increase if we pay attention to each note and give the gamakam properly. Speed can come later, but first clarity and depth. So this is one small point I feel like sharing. Then we take one small nishana. So we have two values. In the Melkata 72 system, we have three values. We'll forget that now. Just take the big ni and small ni. So sa ni is one ni. Sa ni is one. So that is small ni. So small, big ni, small ni, that's all. But that same small ni, how it changes in many, many, many ragas. For example, if we take Bhairavi, so ni da ni sa ti sa ni da ba. So we are saying ni, but it starts on the big da. Ni, ni, re, sa, ri. So that ni. Same small ni starts in todi. So da, the small da is the same. Ni, ni, is different. Talking about ni only, but ni. Then we take another raga, like suruti. Ri ma pa ni 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 da ni sa ni da pa ma pa ni ma. So we are saying da 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 na na. This is also ni. Na is also ni. Na. All these is small ni only. But we take For example, this I learned from my Veena Guru, Professor K.S. Narayana Swami sir. He used to say, many people, when they sing Panisa in Kedar Gaula and Padasa in Kambodi, they sing same thing only. Panisa di. So, this is the note they use. Kambodi also, Maga Padasa. So, Padasa and Panisa, same one. So in vocal we can say da or ni, but instrumental, his idea was that in Kedar Gola ni, you do gamakam very hard and oscillate two times. Ni, so one, two, ni, sa. While in Kamboji, don't do that hard. Ma, ga, pa, da, that's all. Pa, da, sa. Even playing da also. So we don't dasajisabada. It's better to avoid. He used to say that. Then talking about me, I remember it's a true thing only. I can't name the name of a temple, but there is one temple where I go to quite frequently. So people who know me, you can imagine which temple. There is a priest who used to chant one shlokam, let us say Shantakaram Bhujagasena. He used to do only two notes. Shantakaram Bhujagasenam Padmanabham Suresam, like that. Ta-ta-ta-da-da-da. Only. So this priest retired. After that another priest came. So when we know music, if we are in a restaurant or in a bus stand or airport, anywhere we hear music, automatically we will listen. Casually also we can't block it out. So this priest came and we know that the other guy has repeated, so people are paying attention also. New guy has come, okay. So he sings, not sings, he's chanting only. There is no shruti. He sings, Chantakaram Bhujasenam Padmanabham Suresam. Like, oh. It sounded so horrible. So it sounded, we feel our blood is freezing and going in the opposite direction. So, what is the sound? But then if you know an instrument, you instantly realize the old guy used to do da sa 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 da, while this guy is saying sa sa ni sa sa ni. So that ni sounds so disgusting, but that same ni we sing Bhagisri, for example, sa ni da ma pa da ga ma da ni. So this Chantakaram, it's not me. When Da came, that same name, Ni, became beautiful. So this Gamakam, again, as I said, Kalyani Shankaravaram, Kalyani always come about, not all the time. As a general rule, this Gamakam, how we handle in South Indian system and North Indian system. No coronavirus is there. We have to keep our throat dry. If I don't drink water, it will become a very dry talk. So, one, we have many jugalbandis which we keep hearing all the time. So, if it is Hindolam, Mohanam, moderately okay. But they take Kalyani, means after 10 minutes, the South Indian guy will be playing Yamanam. The North Indian will never play Kalyani. At least I have not done. So our Kalyani has gamakams in all the notes. Re, ga, ma, da, ni, re, ga, na. So all these notes have gamakam. Then only, like I said, Kalyani and Sakalapranam, on book only one note is different. Similarly, Kalyani and Yaman, on paper it's same. But in practice they are completely different. So Kalyani, Yaman, let us leave that. But other ragas, like the Gandharam in Abhogi or Kannada. What we do in Carnatic music is we take the ga from re and push it up. Sa re ga ma da ma da sa da ma ga re da sa re ga re ga ga re sa re sa ga. So it's almost re ma re ma re. While the Hindustani guy, from the above note they will drop down. So, da sa re ga, so, maga, maga, maga. Garudasa, Garudasa, Ma, Dasa, Di, Gari, Ma, Da, Ga, Ma, Gari. This is one. Even if you take Chakravaka, Sari, Sa, Da, Ni, Sari, Ga, Ma, Pa, Ta, Ta, Da, 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 Da. So Dhani, Sari, so from Da, Da we are pushing Ni, and Sa, Ri, Sa, Ri. When Hindustani in Ahir Bhairav, Dhani, Ni, Ni, Sa, Sari, Ga, Ma, Da, Ma, Ri. So Ni, Gari, Gari, Gari. So that gives a melancholic and different feeling. The same in Carnatic ragas also, which Hindustani have taken, like Sarasangi or Charukesi, all that. We sing Kripaya Palaya Samure Na 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 Reza ga ga ma da pa. This feel is there in Hindustani, though they have taken our raga, because of which some of these alapana phrases will have a sad tinge. So when we were small children and we had only Doordarshan and no other TV channel, some prime minister, president, they die means 1 week they will show morning music. So the morning music will. The most auspicious thing in Indian music is percussion. So, for inauspicious thing, percussion will not be there. So, there will be one sitar or shehnai or somebody. They will take Subhabandharali or some darbari kanda. And we switch on TV and they will be sitting and playing Subhabandharali. It reached a point where, suppose national program is music is there, you switch on TV and you see Subhabandharali, you go, hey, who died? It became like that. Because of the sad feeling. Actually, I feel classical music should be taken out of that association. We should feel it's a happy thing, it's an auspicious thing. So that is one point. So actually, I'm just touching and going because of the very short time duration. Then we can take something little technical like Suti Bhedam. So Suti Bhedam is when we take the notes of one scale. We'll take a very, very simple one like Mohanam, for example. Then we shift the position of the Sa. So when Sa is shifted, all the other notes will get shifted. So, without Gamakam, Sa Re Ga Pa Da Sa Da Pa Ga Re Sa Mohanam. We take Re. Re Ga Pa Da Sa Re. So when Sa, Sa shifted to Re becomes Sa. So, upper Re also. Sa, 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 Pa, Sa. So Sa, Re, Ma, Pa, Ni, Sa, Ni, Pa, Ma, Re, Sa. It becomes Madhyamavati notes, which in the Hindustani system they call it Meghmala. Why we can't sing Madhyamavati purely is because Sa, Re, Ma, Pa, Ni. We can't do because when we sing Ni with Suti Bhedam, Sa will be shaking. Which I personally feel in Suti Bhedam, even if you do Suti Bhedam, Sa Pa, we should not shake. So, Sa Re Ga Pa Da Sa Da Pa Ga Ri Sa, Sa Re Ma Pa Ni Sa, Sa Ni Pa Ma Re Sa. Madhyamavati. Ga Ga Pa Da Sa Ki Ka, Sa Ga Ma Da. Ni sa ni da ma ga sa hindola bege pa da sa ri ga pa. So that our Shuddha Savari notes sa ri ma pa da sa da pa ma re sa. This Shuddha Savari. But when we know instrument, just like talking, what is the alphabet A B C D E F? Like that, we can just easily shift sa in all the notes without even thinking. Like, oh, we have to be very careful. Hey, first I will sing Mohanam notes. pada sariga paga risada paga pada sariga risada paga riga pada sari sada paga ri sariga pada sada paga ri da sariga pada paga risada pada sariga pa. Now each I'll shift pa to sa, ga to sa, ri to sa, then all the other notes will change. So if you don't know instrument also, you can do that. But it is so much more easy if you know instrument. So once I was spending time with Balamurlikrishna sir, who is big into Shruti Bhedam also. So he has made a raga called Lavangi, which has only four notes. Sa, small ri, small ma and small dha. So sa ri ma dha. Sada Maris of this. So this is just as a background I'm saying. So actually all the Swaram Swara Shruti Bhedam ideas, though I sing, all the Shruti Bhedam ideas I got when I was playing Veena, not when I was singing. So once on Veena I was playing Chandra Jyoti Raga. So Chandra Jyoti, as most of you will know. Da Bama Pada Sada Bama Maga Gama Pada Pama Gari Risada Sari. So Sa first Ri first Ga Ma Pada Sa Sada Pama Gari. But I was playing Veena without touching Sa and Pa. Then suddenly some familiar feeling came and I realized that if you do in Chandra Jyoti Re ga ma da ri, re da ma ga ri becomes sa re ma da sa da ma re.